ओके माय वॉइस इज ऑडिबल टू ऑल? यस
यस मैम.
ओके. नाउ इट्स योर टास्क, यू हैव टू जस्ट डिस्क्राइब योर सेल्फ. बाय फॉर डिस्क्राइबिंग योर सेल्फ यू कैन यूज एनी वर्ड यू कैन यूज. ओके and try to use maximum words, or you can say try to use maximum objectives. Okay, for example, suppose my name is Pratibha, so I'm going to describe myself by using different words like Pratibha. I can say pretty, then patient, peaceful, powerful, etc. Okay, now it's your turn. We'll take name one by one. Okay, we'll start with Kulkarni. Okay, who is ready to answer? Just start yourself quick.
Yes ma'am.
Okay, Archana, describe yourself. Your name is Archana. Okay. with the letter A.
Yes, A. Astha.
Okay.
Enthusiastic.
Enthusiastic, that is A.
Oh, sorry. Atmanirbhar.
Yes, you can say Atmanirbhar. Very nice.
Then, Asha.
Okay, Asha.
Asha, Atmanirbhar. Then, Atma.
Okay.
Then,
okay. Now we will try the second. Asha, are you there? Please unmute yourself.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, two Ashas are there, I think.
Yes, two Ashas.
Asha Hedge.
Yeah, Hedge.
Yes.
From the beginning letter only we have to tell.
Yes, na? Yes, yes. From the beginning letter. That is your letter is Asha, na? You have to. You start, supposed to start with A.
Start from A. Aesthetic.
Okay.
Awesome.
Okay.
Ambitious.
Very nice. Okay, now we'll give chance to someone else. Who is ready to answer? I want volunteers. Okay, we'll select anyone. Okay, Sonal, unmute yourself. Sonal Godbole. Sonal, are you there? Okay, we'll select another person. Dipali. Dipali. Okay, who is ready to answer? Please unmute yourself and answer. Describe yourself. Yes, Sonali.
Hello.
Yes,
yeah, S stands things.
Okay. Okay, Sonali.
Yes. For nature.
Actually, I'm getting cracking noise. Your voice is not properly audible.
Is it audible, ma'am? Is it audible?
Okay, now it is audible.
As for soft nature and sincere and okay. Spiritual.
Okay, very nice. Good try. Okay, now we'll select Ranjita. Unmute yourself fast.
Yes, ma'am. Are from Radiance.
Okay.
Rapid.
Rapid, okay, good.
Means quickly, doing anything quickly, I can say.
Okay.
But आर में ज्यादा वर्ड मिलता नहीं.
अरे ढूंढो भाई, ढूंढो. आपको तो कितना टाइम दिया था मैंने. ओके ओके, दिस वाज जस्ट सेशन ऑफ आइस
ब्रेकर.
ओके ओके, नाउ
रेयर आल्सो मैम, रेयर आल्सो वी
विल नेवर फाइंड रंजिता person like Ranjita, okay?
Okay.
Okay, it's okay. This was just icebreaker session. Total 15 participants are there. So we are supposed to start with today's session, okay? So let's have quick recap of the previous session. In the previous lecture, we have learned about the different functions of management, and we have started one theory, that is Fiol's theory of management. And in that, just tell me, what do you understand by the Fiol's theory of management? Yes, tell me one by one. Yes. Okay, can you tell me other names of the Fiol's theory of management? Just try to recall. No? Okay, the another name for the Fiol's theory of management, that is? Yes. Yes.
Kuresha.
Yes, it is also called as administrative theory of management or administrative management theory. It is the one more name is there, that is Fiolism. You can say the Fiol's theory. Okay. The duration of the Fiol was, it is, just try to recall, it is from 1841 to 1925. And Fiol, he proposed six functions of management and 14 principles of management. And all the functions are there in the definition given by the Henry Fiol. The definition was, just try to recall, it was the very simple definition. Just try to recall the definition. Yes. To manage means to yes to management to forecast and you are not remembering anything. To management mean to forecast, to plan, to organize. Yes, yes, Meenakshi, to organize. Just unmute yourself and try to answer.
Commanding.
Yes, to organize, to command, to coordinate, and to control. So here, in his definition, total six functions of the management are reflected. The functions are forecasting, planning, organizing, then commanding, coordinating, and controlling. And today we are going to touch the new topic regarding the same, that is the Fiol's theory, that is principles of management given by the Henry Fiol. Sonali, now my voice is audible to you. Yes, Sonali. Okay, now I'm going to share my screen. Okay, screen is visible to all?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Okay, see, this is the picture of Henry Fiol. And now we're going to learn about the 14 principles of management given by the Henry Fiol. Okay, we'll start with the first function, that is division of work. Okay, just read it and tell me what you understand by after reading this. Just 1 minute. Okay. The first principle is division of work.
Work should be divided according to the departments and the specialized people. in the organization.
Okay, good.
Ma'am, FIOLS specifically specifies the specialization of the work done by the employee to use the human resource in the best possible way.
Very nice answer. Okay, anyone try to answer?
Work should be divided in small parts to accomplish the big goal.
Okay, excellent answer, Meenal. Okay, so division of work means what? See, okay, now I'm expecting some examples from your side. Then we'll discuss on this.
Ma'am, say as a sales department, marketing department, the work is divided in a small division, can say sectors. So the person able to do within very specialized manner.
Okay, excellent answer. See, she gave example regarding the commerce sector, the selling department is there, production department is there. So here the work is divided among individuals. It can be divided individually or it can be divided in a group. Okay. To ensure that effort and attentions are focused on a special portion of the task. So basically here, FIOL, he focuses on the work specialization. Okay, so here we can take example of a tailor. Previously also we took this example. Tailor, aap kisi bhi tailor ke paas jaate ho, to wahan pe kya rehta hai? Wahan pe ek hi task. See, dekho, aapne kya kiya? Aap ek kaam karne ke liye gaye ho. आपको क्या करना है? आपको ड्रेस स्टिच करवा के लेके आना है. लेकिन ड्रेस स्टिच करवा करना एक ही काम नहीं है, उसमें बहुत सारे छोटे छोटे काम है. ठीक है, तो सबसे पहले आप जाओगे तो कोई है रहेगा आपका मेजरमेंट लेगा. उसके बाद जो कपड़ा रहेगा उसको अगर जरूरत पड़ेगी तो उसको वॉश किया जाएगा, नहीं है तो उसको कटिंग किया जाएगा. कटिंग करने के बाद उसको स्टिच किया जाएगा. स्टिच करने के बाद उसको ओवरलॉकिंग किया जाएगा. ओवरलॉकिंग के बाद उसको आइनिंग किया जाएगा और बाद में कस्टमर को वो डिस्पैच किया जाएगा. सो दैट इज नथिंग बट, तो यहाँ पे क्या होता है, वहां पे जरूरी नहीं, यहाँ पे हो सकता है वहां पे एक ही वर्कर हो सकता है. देयर इज अ वर्क ग्रुप ऑफ वर्कर्स. ओके, सो हियर FIOL प्रेजेंटेड वर्क स्पेशलाइजेशन एज द बेस्ट वे टू यूज ह्यूमन रिसोर्सेस ऑफ द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. So this is also known as, so we see this is the name of this principle, is division of work. It is also known as task specialization. That is nothing but breaking up a big task into smaller parts and then assigning the particular smaller task to the individuals, or we can say to the group of people. That is nothing but the division of work. Now I'm expecting one example from your side regarding any educational institution. Okay, understood about this, the division of work?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, now try to give me one example regarding educational institution.
Ma'am, teachers.
Yes, can you elaborate, please?
Ma'am, say as English teacher, mathematics teacher.
Very nice example, Kuresa. See, see, after completion of your B.Ed. course, you will be a teacher. And suppose when you enter in any school, or when you will get recruitment in any school, and the principal, he told you, you have to teach all the subject for all the classes. Is it possible for you? Of course, it is not possible for you. So there is a specialization of the subject. A particular teacher is only for the particular subject, only for the particular level, only for the particular class, you can say. Okay. So here there is a division of the subject. So teaching, it is a one task, but it is not possible for a single person. So here, as a higher level manager, what principle he will do? He will allocate, or you can divide the work or divide the task of teaching among the different teachers. So for example, Kuresha, she will teach a science method for the 5th class and for the 7th class. So that can be a division of work. Understood about this division of work? See, in your exam, the question will be, explain principles of management given by Henry FIOL with one example of each. Okay, so that can be, this kind of question can be asked in the final examination or in your prelim examination. Okay, or explain different principles of management given by the Henry Fayol, and how these principles they are applicable in the school education. So this question can be asked in your final exam or in the prelim examination. So here you should know about the different principles and its applicability in the school or in the college level. In short, you can say in the educational institution. Okay, understood about the first principle of management? Should we move ahead? Okay. See, the next function is authority. Okay, authority means what? See, most of the time we are saying that whenever there is the authority, there is a responsibility. So we can say these two concepts, that is authority and responsibility, they are closely related. So authority was defined by Henry Fayol as the right, it is a right to give orders and the power to exact obedience. Okay, so yahan pe kya hai, kisi ko right diya gaya hai order dene ka, that is nothing but the authority. Responsibility involves being accountable and is therefore naturally associated with the authority. Of course, there is a connection between authority and responsibility, kyunki jisko authority diya hai, that is the only person who is responsible for the particular task. Okay, so here authority and responsibility, they goes hand in hand. Whoever assumes authority also assumes responsibility. Okay, here see, it is each level manager should know and carry out all responsibilities assigned to him in a proper manner. So here see, there are different levels of manager, higher level manager, you can say middle level and lower level. So each level manager, there is some kind of authority is given to each level manager, isn't it? So it's duty of each level manager to carry out all the responsibilities, because authority and responsibilities, they goes hand in hand, assigned to him in proper manner. Okay, who will try me to give example of authority? Yes,
principal.
Yes, can you elaborate?
Principal has the authority to command or give instruction to teachers.
Okay, so principal is having authority, he can give instructions regarding the anything, regarding any event, regarding any meeting, regarding the code of conduct. He can give instructions to the employees working under him. But if that employees, they are not doing their job properly, then who will be the responsible?
Coordinator.
Yes, the principal, because he is the authorized person. And as you know, the authority and responsibility, they goes hand in hand. They are very closely related. So authority, authorized person, yes, I am authorized person, so I am having right, I can give orders to the subordinates or the employees working under me, but it's my responsibility to suppose the teachers, they are not doing their job properly, or they are not giving 100%. So who will be the responsible? Here the teachers, they are not responsible. Here the principal is responsible, because he is the authorized person, right? So management, he will ask that principal about the any mistake done by the teacher, isn't it? यहाँ पे क्या होता है, authority के साथ जो authorized person रहता है वही responsible रहता है. अगर मुझे authority, मुझे कोई management ने एक task दिया है, तो ये मेरी responsibility है कि वो task पूरा करवा लेना. अगर मेरे under जितने भी employees है उनसे वो करवा लेना, वो मेरी जिम्मेदारी है. लेकिन जो मेरे ऊपर अथॉरिटी है उसके लिए रिस्पॉन्सिबल है, उनको उनको जवाब देने के लिए कौन रिस्पॉन्सिबल है? यहाँ पे प्रिंसिपल रिस्पॉन्सिबल है. ओके, सो इट इज द ड्यूटी ऑफ ईच लेवल मैनेजर टू नो एंड कैरी आउट ऑल द रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटीज असाइन टू हिम इन प्रॉपर मैनर. अंडरस्टूड अबाउट द अथॉरिटी? यस और नो? शुड वी मूव अहेड? यस
मैम.
ओके ओके. डिसिप्लिन, जस्ट रीड इट. Discipline means what? Just read this slide once.
Follow rules and regulation, be punctual.
Okay, we have to follow rules and regulations. We have to be punctual. Okay. See.
And regulation is in SOPs. Will the company decide or can institute decide to which need to be followed by from a higher authority to the lower level of the employees who's working within company.
Yes. So can we see the rules and regulations are the same for all the employees or all levels of managers?
Ma'am, it differs basically whoever having a more authority, they are having liberty on the same hand.
Yes, very nice, Suresha. See, the simple meaning of discipline, it is nothing but the rules and regulation. Agar hum dekhte ghar mein bhi rules and regulations rehte, lekin zaruri nahi hai ki, see, as she said, so it differs. Zaruri nahi ki sabke liye rules and regulations same hi ho. Maybe there is a variation. अगर आपको एज अ गर्ल अगर आपको बोला गया है कि आपको 7 बजे से पहले घर आना है, ये आपके लिए क्या है, एक रूल एंड रेगुलेशन है, तो आपको ये डिसिप्लिन फॉलो करना है. लेकिन आप ऐसे नहीं बोल सकते ना, नहीं भैया को भी 7 बजे से पहले आना है. इट डिफर्स, वहां पे वेरिएशंस होंगे. सो हियर द मेन द सिंपल मीनिंग ऑफ डिसिप्लिन इज टू ओबे रूल्स एंड रेगुलेशंस. इट डिफर्स लेवल वाइज. ओके, but all level managers need to follow discipline with efficient functioning of the for efficient functioning of the institution. So yahan pe sabhi level managers ko means the whoever is the part of that institution or organization, that person supposed to follow all the rules and regulations of that particular institution. Because a successful organization requires the common efforts of the worker. See, अगर किसी को किसी ऑर्गेनाइजेशन को सक्सेसफुल होना है, उसके लिए सभी के एफर्ट्स चाहिए. ऐसे नहीं हो सकता कि किसी ने एक कोई एक पंक्चुअल है, कोई एक डिसिप्लिन है, उसी ने ही काम किया, उसी की वजह से वो ऑर्गेनाइजेशन सक्सेसफुल नहीं होता. बिकॉज इट इज अ कॉमन एफर्ट्स ऑफ अ वर्कर्स, यू कैन से कॉमन एफर्ट्स ऑफ एम्प्लॉइज ऑफ दैट इंस्टीट्यूशन और द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. द मेन इज द पेनाल्टी शुड बी एम्प्लॉयड judiciously to encourage these common efforts. Okay, can you give me one example regarding this? Just try to give. Penalties means what? See, discipline means what, we have to obey or we have to follow particular rules and regulations laid by the institutions or the particular organization. But whenever we are not obeying that rules and regulations, at that time there should be penalty. The penalty is in the form of
leaving a job, either paying some money.
See, also it also differs. So there are
late marks.
Very nice. I think Meenal, she answered about the late marks. See, the penalties means what? When I did my B.Ed at that time, so our institution or our college, they make us that your attendance should be 100%. Okay, so whenever we were going on, अगर हम ऐसे होते, हम एक दिन भी कॉलेज नहीं जाते थे, तो हमको 100 rupees का फाइन बैठता था. ठीक है, एक दिन के लिए. अगर आपको पता है यूनिवर्सिटी का ये रूल है कि आपको 80% अटेंडेंस होना चाहिए, लेकिन हमारे कॉलेज में वो उनका ये था कि 100% अटेंडेंस होना ही चाहिए. अगर आपका 100% नहीं है, अगर आप एक दिन भी आप नहीं आ रहे कॉलेज में, तो यू हैव टू पे पेनाल्टीज. तो हमें 100 rupees फाइन बैठता था, प्रॉपर अकाउंटेंट के पास वो 100 rupees हमें भरने पड़ते थे, और उसके बाद वो रिसिप्ट जब हम क्लास टीचर को बताते थे, उसी बाद हमको एंट्री मिलती थी नेक्स्ट डे कॉलेज में. ठीक है, so that is a part of discipline. अगर आप कोई भी rules and regulation follow नहीं कर रहे हो, so आपको penalties भरनी पड़ेगी. so this is related to the students. can you give me example of teacher? as Meenal said, you have to be punctual. suppose your school timing is 10 to 5, so you have to be there before 10. अगर आपको 10 से थोड़ा सा भी आपको लेट होता है, तो क्या होगा, क्या होगा अगर आप लेट जा रहे हो, तो
लेट मार्क,
लेट रिमार्क.
यस, आपको लेट रिमार्क मिलेगा. और लेट रिमार्क, आपको पता है कि आपको 3 लेट रिमार्क मिलेगी, तो ऑटोमेटिकली आपका एक कैजुअल लीव आपका उसमें से डिडक्ट होने वाला है. ठीक है, सो दैट इज अ काइंड ऑफ penalty. Okay, understood about the discipline?
And even ma'am, memos also.
Yes, memos also. Very nice point. Who tell this?
Asha,
very nice. Okay, so memos. बहुत बार ऐसे होता है कि कोई कोई भी एक इवेंट आप करने जा रहे हैं, मतलब कोई ऑर्गेनाइजेशन करने जा रहा है और उसमें कोई किसी की वजह से वहां पे कुछ दिक्कत आई या फिर उसका कुछ एक फ्लॉप शो हो गया, तो वो टाइम पे क्या होता है कि दिस पर्टिकुलर पर्सन इज रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर दिस. ये जो भी हुआ है इसके लिए ये पर्टिकुलर पर्सन ही रिस्पॉन्सिबल है, अगर ऐसे समझ में आता है, या फिर इसी की वजह से पूरा मेसअप हो गया, तो वहां पे हायर लेवल अथॉरिटी क्या करती है, उसको मेमो देती है. ओके, that is also part of penalty. Okay, understood about the discipline? See, I have not displayed any example of actual applicability of the principle of management given by the Henry Fayol in any educational institutions. Agar aapko ye samajh mein aata hai ki actual principles kya hai, then you can apply these principles in educational institutions, isn't it? Okay. The next principle is unity of command. Okay, previously we saw the three principle. The first principle was the division of work. The second was, yes, which was the second principle? It was the
unity of command.
I'm asking about the second principle, dear.
Authority and responsibility.
Yes, authority and responsibility. And third was discipline. And this is the fourth one. That is, yes, this is the fourth one. That is unity of command. Okay, see, workers should receive orders from only one manager. There should be proper command over all levels of manager, and employees should receive instruction from his superior and should be accountable to only one superior. Okay, now tell me, what do you understood about this
one flow of order?
Very nice. That is nothing but the one flow of order. अगर आप एक किसी एक से ही आपको orders मिलनी चाहिए, so see, workers should receive order only from one manager. So there are different level managers. अगर ऐसे होता है कि आपको प्रतिभा मैम भी कुछ instructions देती है regarding the same, अगर आपको रोकड़े मैम भी instructions देते हैं, तो वहां पे क्या हो जाएगा, आप कंफ्यूज हो जाओगे. अब बहुत बार ऐसे होता है, so there should be unity of command. Okay. So here the principal teachers are getting orders from the principal. So we can say teachers are receiving instructions from the principal. Here the principal, or you can say the higher level managers, not higher level, but the principal, he is getting instructions from the trustee members. So you can say the management, that can be an example of unity of command. Okay, understood? Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, okay. Then the next is unity of direction. Just try to read, and whatever you understood about this slide, just tell me. Yes, who is ready to explain about this point, that is unity of direction? It is very simple.
Common goal achievement.
Yes.
Like ma'am, schools or institutions have their own vision and missions. So everyone is working for that.
See, if we see, there is a vision, there is a mission, there are certain objectives also that are enlisted there. So these are nothing but the directions where to go. If we don't know, हमें पता ही नहीं हमें जाना कहाँ है. अगर आप घर से निकले, बाइक लेके निकले आप, और आपको पता ही नहीं आपको जाना कहाँ, आप कहाँ जाओगे, आप इधर उधर भटकते रहोगे. तो उसके लिए क्या होना चाहिए, यू शुड हैव प्रॉपर डायरेक्शन. सो वॉट एवर ऑब्जेक्टिव और विजन, मिशन, ऑब्जेक्टिव laid by that particular organization, it gives direction to the employees where to go, isn't it? So there should be proper guideline for all level managers to follow an order in order to achieve the predetermined goal. See, this is nothing but the planning. The goal and objective, they are laid by the institutions before the execution or in advance. Okay. So, आपको पता होना चाहिए आपको कहाँ जाना है, ठीक है, लेकिन उसके लिए कुछ तो होना चाहिए. सो देयर शुड बी एक्शन प्लान. एन एक्शन प्लान नीड्स टू बी प्रिपेयर विच एक्ट एज अ गाइडलाइन एंड प्रोवाइड्स डायरेक्शन टू ऑल द एम्प्लॉयज इन द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. सो कैन यू कोरिलेट दिस विद द एनी एजुकेशन इंस्टीट्यूशन? यस. How can
Hello, ma'am.
Yes.
Yeah, जैसे अभी ये सिचुएशन में ऑनलाइन मतलब एजुकेशन स्टॉप ना हो इसलिए ऑनलाइन प्लेटफॉर्म क्रिएट किया गया है. तो ये भी डायरेक्शन हो जाएगा कि हमें हमारा सिलेबस कंप्लीट करना है. तो जैसे आप सब जूम एज अ जूम पे जूम यूज करके आप अपना सिलेबस कंप्लीट कर रहे हो.
ओके. आपको क्या समझ में आया? अभी किसने बात किया? आई थिंक
सोनाली मैम.
ओके सोनाली, यूनिटी ऑफ डायरेक्शन से आपको क्या समझ आया ये मुझे बताओ आप पहले.
जैसे हमें गोल अगर कोई गोल अचीव करना है तो सब उसके लिए एक परफेक्ट डायरेक्शन होना चाहिए और सब मिलके मतलब उसके लिए
वो गोल. हाँ, सबको एक साथ काम करना है ताकि आपको जो आपका जो गोल है वो आपको अचीव करना है, ठीक है. लेकिन उसके लिए आपको क्या चाहिए? प्रॉपर एक्शन प्लान चाहिए. उसके लिए आपको एक प्रॉपर डायरेक्शन चाहिए. तो वो गोल और ऑब्जेक्टिव अगर आपका आप हम इसको स्कूल से कोरिलेट करते हैं. जैसे कि देखो अभी एडमिशन्स तो हुए है, ठीक है, ऑनलाइन एडमिशन्स हुए है, लेकिन आपका टारगेट क्या है? अभी देखो हम ऑब्जेक्टिव की बात करें क्योंकि गोल दैट इज द लॉन्ग टर्म achievement we can say. So here our objective is we have to finish particular percentage syllabus within this 1 month. But because of this pandemic situation, it is not possible for every school. So now they have prepared the another action plan for the completion of the syllabus of the all subject in a school. So that action plan, it involves the online classes. Okay. So that can be an example, but this direction, it is given by the whom? It is given by the management, we can say, or it is given by the higher level authority. So as per their action plan, all teachers are working on the same, isn't it? Understood about the unit of direction? Yes or no?
Yeah.
Okay. Okay, then next is subordination of individual interest to the general interest. Okay. See, the interest of one person should not take priority over the interest of the organization as a whole. It means that the employees working in an institution should forget their own gains and benefits for the growth and development of an institution. ओके, क्या समझ में आया आपको इससे?
एक्सक्यूज मी मैम.
यस.
एज अ स्कूल थ्रू देखा जाए तो मैम, अगर एक मैम वन ईयर शी विल वर्क मैम, आफ्टर दैट शी विल लीव द स्कूल, देन स्कूल विल नॉट डिपेंड ऑन दैट टीचर ओनली, शी विल द स्कूल विल सर्च अनदर स्कूल ऑल्सो, अनदर टीचर ऑल्सो.
Okay, you understood this by reading this particular six principles of management. Yes, Archana?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, see. Someone try to answer? Someone try to explain? Yes?
The employee of the organization should not focus on his personal interest. He should focus on the organization, means general interest of the organization.
Okay, good try, Meenal. See. Subordination of individual interest to the general interest. See, the interest of one person should not take priority over the interest of organization as a whole. It means that the employees working in an institution should forget their own gains and benefits for the growth and development of the institution. यहाँ पे कोई भी काम इसलिए करना है ताकि मुझे बेनिफिट हो, इसलिए कोई भी काम नहीं करना है. सी एज अ पार्ट ऑफ दैट इंस्टीट्यूशन यू हैव टू गिव 100%, बट हियर यू हैव टू फॉरगॉट अबाउट योर ओन गेन्स. जस्ट थिंक अबाउट, यू हैव टू थिंक ओनली अबाउट द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. ओके, तो अगर आप 100% दोगे तो किसका फायदा होने वाला है? ऑर्गेनाइजेशन का. तो यहाँ पे आपको खुद के बारे में नहीं सोचना है. ओके, दैट इज नथिंग बट द सबऑर्डिनेशन ऑफ इंडिविजुअल इंटरेस्ट टू द जनरल इंटरेस्ट. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, सपोज सडनली देयर इज अ कमिटी. अगर आपको आज ही प्रिंसिपल ने बता दिया कि 2 दिन के बाद या फिर नेक्स्ट वीक में एक कोई कमिटी, स्टेट गवर्नमेंट की कमिटी आने वाली है जो आपके स्कूल का असेसमेंट करेगी. सो एज अ टीचर, व्हाट इज योर जॉब? आप ऐसे बोलोगे क्योंकि आपको अगर आपके पास अगर टाइम कम है तो आपको हार्डवर्क करना पड़ेगा, आपको एक्स्ट्रा टाइम एक्स्ट्रा या फिर आपको ओवर टाइम वर्क करना पड़ेगा. तो अब क्या आप ऐसे बोलेगी नहीं मुझे तो इसका कोई ओवर टाइम नहीं दे रहे तो मैं नहीं करूंगा या फिर मैं नहीं करूंगी? ठीक है, अगर हेलो हेलो आपको समझ में आ रहा है मैं क्या कह रही हूँ? तो आपको यहाँ के यस पर्सनल गेन्स जो भी है वो आपको बाजू में रखने, या जस्ट ओनली एज अ एम्प्लॉई और एज अ पार्ट ऑफ दैट इंस्टीट्यूशन और ऑर्गेनाइजेशन, जस्ट यू हैव टू थिंक अबाउट द योर ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस गेन ओनली, नॉट अबाउट योर ओन गेन्स, इजंट इट? सो दैट इज नथिंग बट द सबऑर्डिनेशन ऑफ इंडिविजुअल इंटरेस्ट टू द जनरल इंटरेस्ट. ओके, द नेक्स्ट. Yes, understood about the previous subordination of the individual interest to the general interest? Yes?
Yes, yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. The next point is remuneration. Remuneration means what? Can you tell me the meaning of remuneration? Have you heard this word before? Yes?
Salary.
रिमेनरेशन का मतलब जिसको हम मानधन बोल सकते हैं, आपने कोई भी काम किया तो उसका मुबदला मिलना, किसके इसमें? पैसे के इसमें. ठीक है, तो कोई भी काम जिसको हम लोग इन शॉर्ट हम उसको मानधन बोलते हैं. ठीक है, सी द मेनी वेरिएबल्स ईच एंड एवरी ऑर्गेनाइजेशन सपोज टू कंसिडर डिफरेंट वेरिएबल्स while deciding the salary of the worker, or we can say while deciding the salary of an employee. So which variables they are? We have to think about the cost of the living, supply of the qualified person, general business conditions, success of the business, everything. All these variables have to consider by the management while determining the worker's rate of pay. कोई भी worker की salary तय करने से पहले मैनेजमेंट को क्या डिसाइड करना है? अगर देखो आज हम बोलते हैं ये महंगा हो गया, महंगाई बहुत बढ़ गई है, इवन बेसिक नीड्स भी हम पूरे नहीं कर पा रहे. सो व्हाई डिटरमाइनिंग द सैलरी ऑफ द पर्टिकुलर एम्प्लॉई इन हु इज द पार्ट ऑफ दैट ऑर्गेनाइजेशन, द मैनेजमेंट शुड थिंक अबाउट द डिफरेंट वेरिएबल्स. अभी देखो बिकॉज ऑफ दिस पैंडेमिक सिचुएशन इवन द मैनेजमेंट दे आर फेसिंग वेरी प्रॉब्लम. ओके, बट दे अगर आपका रेगुलर क्लासेस चल भी नहीं रहे हैं लेकिन फिर भी मैनेजमेंट को पे करना पड़ रहा है जो भी एम्प्लॉयज उसमें काम कर रहे हैं, लेकिन वो क्या कर रहे हैं अभी फुल पे नहीं कर रहे. आपको भी शायद एक्सपीरियंस होगा, दे आर नॉट पेइंग द होल सैलरी, बट इंस्टेड ऑफ दैट दे आर पेइंग 50% 60% सैलरी टू द एम्प्लॉयज. ओके, सैलरी शुड बी गिवन अकॉर्डिंग टू द वर्क डन बाय एवरी इंडिविजुअल. Remuneration should be provided according to the output and quality of the work done. जिस तरीके का काम है, जिस तरीके का काम वो करते हैं, कौन से quality से करे, उसी के accordingly salary देना चाहिए. Okay, that is about the remuneration. Understood about this? Yes.
Hello.
Or no?
Yeah, yes. Good afternoon, ma'am.
Good afternoon, Geeta ma'am.
Yeah.
Okay.
Ma'am.
Okay. We'll wind up my session. Okay.
Okay.
Okay. So just now we are focused on the seven principles of management. Okay. Just have quick recap of this. Tell me one by one about first principle was. Yes.
Division of work.
Okay. Division of work means what? What is the another name for division of work?
Means a big work should be divided into small parts to be to work done properly.
Okay, that is nothing but the very nice answer. That is nothing but the task specialization. And the second was, that is nothing but the second principle of management was
authority
and responsibility.
Yes, authority and responsibility. They are very very closer, because whenever there is an authority, that person should be accountable for the responsibility. And third principle was, yes,
discipline.
Disciplines are nothing but
follow rules and regulations.
Yes, the simple meaning, that is, there are the rules and regulations. Maybe there is a variation regarding the rules and regulations for the particular level managers, but everyone who is a part of that institution should obey all the rules and regulations. And one more thing was there, if anyone is not obeying the rules and regulations laid by the institution, then there should be, yes, there should be
penalty.
Yes, there should be penalty. Then next was unity of, tell me fast, unity of
command.
Means what? Unity of command means what?
Means there should be one bus and the orders should be unidirectional.
Top level management. No.
Yes, means orders should be, or we can say command should be given by one top level manager to the lower level manager, and the lower level manager, they should be only accountable to only one person, who is at top level. Okay, that is nothing but the unity of command. The next is
unity of direction.
They should, the employees or the each and every person who is part of that institution should know where to go. So already objectives and goals laid down by that institution. We took the example of the recent example we took, that is regarding this pandemic situation, right? So now the action plan, each and every school, they have changed their action plan about the teaching. Okay. So all the teachers, they are getting direction how to teach. The next is what was the sixth one? Try to recall. Yes,
there should be general interest.
Yes, you can say the subordination of the individual interest to the general interest. The employee, they should not take care of their own benefits or own gains, but they have to think about the benefits of that organization. That is nothing but the subordination of the individual interest to the general interest. And just now we saw about the remuneration, that is nothing but what we call, that is mandhan. Okay, but while determining the salary of any worker, any employee in that organization, the management should take care of the, should think about the different variables like the cost of living, supply of the qualified person, etc. Okay, and the salary should be given as per the quality of the work done by that particular employee. So this is all about the seven principles of management given by the Henry Fiol. Okay, and I'm going to stop my screen sharing. Geeta ma'am?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, I'm making you host of this meeting.
Okay, ma'am.
I'm just searching you. Okay, ma'am, now you are the host of this meeting.
Okay, ma'am, thank you so much, ma'am.
Okay, student, thank you so much. I'm now going to leave this meeting. Okay, take care. Bye-bye. See you in the next session.
Thanks, ma'am.
Okay. Thank you.
Bye-bye, ma'am.